Cancer is the world's leading cause of death. Each year throughout the world, approximately 8 million people die of the disease and about 13 million are diagnosed. American amateur pilot Carrie L. Queen and his colleague Harold Edwin Selick have been working to combat cancer for many years. Their research has ushered in a new era in the fight against this and other diseases, and are giving new hope to millions of people.
Like most people who have dedicated their lives to cancer research, my ultimate vision is to find a cure. Through the efforts of tens of thousands of scientists, a lot of progress has been made, but much more work needs to be done to ultimately conquer this terrible disease.
The story of a friend of Selick's who suffered from a rare form of cancer of the lymphatic system has driven him even further.
Instead of dropping out of school in order to focus on his treatment, this guy actually switched his advisor so that he could work in a lab that was dedicated on cancer research to work on a treatment, if not a cure, for his own disease. And I found that incredibly inspiring, and to this day I'm inspired by that example.
As we age, serious diseases become increasingly common. Queen and Selick's research mimics natural mechanisms in our immune system. They focus on immunoglobulins, antibodies like those produced by our bodies. By means of biotechnological processes, they produce specific artificial antibodies. But what exactly are antibodies?
Antibodies are proteins that are made by the immune system of the body, normally to combat bacteria and viruses.
Just as a key fits a lock, the two arms of the Y-shaped protein latch onto antigens, which are small molecules on the surface of harmful invaders, forming a connection with them. Our immune system attacks the enemy, which has been labeled such by the antibody, and shuts them down. However, in certain diseases, the antibodies do not recognize the antigens. In the case of cancer, this means that the abnormal cells divide and multiply undisturbed. Here, man-made custom antibodies can help.
The field of antibodies, or monoclonal antibodies, was developed by Kohler and Milstein in England in the late 1970s. Work for which they won a Nobel Prize. My particular area within antibodies, humanization, was pioneered by Dr. Greg Winter, also in England.
With the so-called hybridoma technique, Kohler and Milstein for the first time were able to produce antibodies with tailored properties in large amounts. Then they inoculated mice with antigens of the disease to be treated, which these antibodies developed. These cells were isolated and fused with tumor cells. Then cells were sought out that produced the desired antibody, and then these were isolated. Through cell division, genetically identical cells with very specific properties were produced. These are so-called monoclonal antibodies. But there are obstacles to using these antibodies in the human body.
The problem with using mouse monoclonal antibodies in human patients is that the human immune system recognizes them as being a foreign substance and then makes its own antibodies against them, anti-antibodies, you might call that. And these antibodies render the mouse monoclonal antibodies ineffective for further therapy.
This is where Carrie L. Queen and Harold Edwin Selick's patented invention comes in. In the late 80s, they were able to make the antibodies compatible with the human organism.
In order to use mouse antibodies, we take only a little piece of the mouse antibody, the part that you really need to bind to the target, and we combine it with all the rest of a human antibody. So the final result, called a humanized antibody, can be effectively used in human patients.
As a cancer drug, the biotechnologically created antibodies cannot cure the disease, but they do increase life expectancy. In addition, they have the added benefit of protecting the organism. This can be compared to extinguishing a burning candle. Chemotherapy is similar to putting out the candle with a water jet from a fire hose. If too much of the stream misses the target, it negatively affects the healthy environment. The antibody therapy, however, is comparable to targetedly blowing out the candle.
In addition to treating cancer with humanized antibodies, they can be used to treat autoimmune diseases, such as rheumatoid arthritis, and certain infectious diseases, such as respiratory syncytial virus.
Today, the two U.S. researchers' technology is being used in 15 leading drugs. From the two cancer drugs, Herceptin and Avastin alone, several billion euros annually are earned. For their research, the two scientists, Carrie L. Queen and Harold Edwin Selleck, have now been nominated for the European Inventor Award.
Being nominated for the European Inventor Award is a tremendous honor. It recognizes the progress that I and other scientists working with me have made in cancer research.
I think it's an incredible honor to be recognized for this award, and what we did was really the result of a lot of effort as well as creativity, and it's incredibly flattering to be nominated.
Whether the two Americans end up taking home the European Inventor Award, one of the highest awards for researchers and scientists, will be decided this year in Berlin. One thing is for sure, they have given doctors a new weapon in the fight against deadly diseases. And most of all, they have given many people new hope.